Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In this video, I will demonstrate how to use JSON mapping when the input contains a JSON array. The enhancements were added in IBM App Connect Enterprise version 12.0.10. In previous videos, I have shown how to use a simple JSON mapping when a JSON message tree is taken from the output of one node and used in the next node in a flow. I showed how to use a GitHub request node to create an issue in a GitHub repo and then sent the message to Slack afterwards to report that the GitHub issue had been created. In this demo, I will use a similar flow, but for this example, the flow will be retrieving a subset of GitHub issues, and then I'll be using a JSONata map to process them so that they can be shown in a Slack message. I will show different techniques for processing the JSONata map. So here I have a flow which has an HTTP input node, a GitHub request node, a Slack request node, and the HTTP reply node. I am going to be retrieving a list of issues from a GitHub repo, and I'll be only retrieving issues which have a label of bug. I'm going to be using an action of retrieve all. If I bring up the GitHub repo, you can see there are a number of open issues. Four issues which have a label of bug. So I'll be retrieving these four issues using the GitHub request node, and then I'll be listing those issues using the Slack request node. And I'll be taking you through different techniques for processing the array which is returned from the GitHub request node. So I've listed three expressions here which I'll be using in a note in the message flow. I'll be showing the expressions in the description of a YouTube video and in a comment, and I'll also be showing the expression that I used in a associated blog entry that goes with a video. If I click on the open response schema button for the GitHub request node, you can see the schema which describes the response message that is returned from GitHub. As you can see, the array that is returned contains a complex set of items. It would be too much to send all of this information to Slack. So I only want to extract parts of the complex property so that it's sent to Slack. So I'm only interested in sending the number of the issue and the description of the title of the issue. In the Slack request node, I am going to open the discovery wizard, which will show a panel for configuring the Slack request node. For my first attempt, I'm going to list the issues that have been returned. So I'm just going to select the issue number that is returned. So if I save that and close it and save the flow, I already have the integration server running, which is associated with an external credential vault, which has the credentials for the connectors. And I have the policies defined, which are referenced by the nodes, and the policies reference the credentials. So I'm just going to put a message through the flow. I'll just bring up Slack so you can see the message that will come through. So there's no message there at the moment. Redeploy the flow and put a message through. So the message has gone through, and we can see that we have a message in Slack which lists the issues, but it just tells me the issue number for each issue, which has a label of bug. So let's see if we can improve on that. So for the second attempt, I am going to use a map function, which is available in JSONata. It is this expression here, which is shown in the note, and I'm going to use that in the configuration. So I'll just bring up the configuration pane again, And instead of just specify the issue number, I'm going to use this expression here. So if I save that and close the pane and save the flow, if I now redeploy the flow and send a message through, we now see another Slack message, and this time we see an array showing the issue number and the description. So this looks better, but it's shown in the form of a delimited array, which isn't very readable. So let's see if we can improve on that. So for my third attempt, I'm going to use this expression here, which uses a reduce function to iterate through the array which is sent back from GitHub and process it so that it can be shown in Slack in a nice readable way. So let's open the connected discovery wizard again. So let's remove what we had before and use the new expression which uses the reduce function. And I'm going to save this. Close the wizard and save the flow. So now let's redeploy the flow and send a message to the flow. And now we can see the Slack message is shown in a nice readable way. The issue number is shown and the description, and it's shown on a new line. So this video has shown how you can do different types of JSON mapping on a complex JSON array of items. You can see details of how to use the functions which can be used with JSONata in jsonata.org.